All right, guys, so one of the advantages of the Glock 29, and one of the reasons that really led me to purchase this and use it as my everyday carry, is it's a very versatile firearm. If you guys can see here, I have a Lone Wolf Distributors 10mm to 357 SIG conversion barrel. Now, because the 357 SIG is based off of the 40 Smith & Wesson, which in turn is based off of the 10mm, and they have the same outside cartridge dimensions, I'm able to fit 357 SIG into my 10mm magazine and put it right into my Glock 29.
The only place where I notice the snappiness of the 10mm or the 357 SIG is the fact that we have this extended magazine in here, and right here where my pinky goes is where I feel, from the recoil of the gun, I feel a little bit of a slight pinch. So I wouldn't put that as a knock against the Glock 29 at all. It's just that when you use it with the extended magazines, I get just a little pinch right there on my pinky.
All right, guys, this is my Marlin Model 336 30-30 Winchester lever action. Jordan asked me to bring out some toys to play with today that he wasn't necessarily familiar with. This is more of a brush style Old West lever action gun, and he wanted to see what it was going to go ahead and do to his ShootSteel.com plates. So let's take another one, shall we?
Now, you say lever action, not lever action?
Lever, lever.
Lever? Barely know her.
This is my Mossberg 535 12 gauge with some quote-unquote tactical upgrades. Does have the ATI adjustable stock on it with the side saddle shell holder. It also has the Ghost Ring sights on it if you want to take a look down there with that bright orange front sight. I'm running in a 18-inch barrel right now. The nice thing that I like about the Mossberg 535 is it will do your 2 3/4 inch, your 3 inch, or your 3.5 inch shells. So very versatile shotgun. I've been super impressed with it since I got it. Been happy with all the upgrades. Mossberg, you know, reliability, so.
Fast, and it wasn't stuck. The customer service.